Good morning, everybody. On my sheet here, I've got welcome and introduction. So I want you all to welcome as I introduce Alex Wyndham, the student who will be with us until just after Christmas. So if Alex will have the cheek and walk up here, please, so people can see you. You won't miss him. Alex will be around helping out in the parish for the next 4 months. So I hope everyone will make him welcome. He'll be into the school to see the children and the teachers, and he'll be doing all sorts of other getting up to all sorts of other mischief. We'll see how we get on. But we do welcome him and hope he'll be have a happy experience here. Thank you. I'm sure he's calling me everything under the sun. So we will ask Theo to come forward, please. Everybody sit down so we can have the Mass introduced.
Welcome to our first school mass to celebrate the beginning of our school year at St. Michael's. Today, we gather in a spirit of hope as we anticipate a new year of possibilities and new beginnings for all of us in our school community. We may have a mixture of emotions about the coming year. We might feel some anxiety about what is to come. We may feel confident about the weeks ahead. We may still be dreaming about our summer holidays. However we may feel, what we all know is that we will be trying our best in the grace of God in the coming year to reach our full potential. In the words of Catherine of Siena, be who God meant you to be, and you will set the world on fire.
So we stand, please. Sorry about the noise outside. This is the first time during Mass that we've had that noise. So probably because we've started 9:30 instead of 9:00. But we're here to celebrate a very, very special birthday. Mary, the mother of Jesus. It's a birthday today, and we celebrate it with great joy and happiness. And ask Mary, our mother now, to protect us and to guide us throughout the day and throughout our lives. Just pause for a moment now and ask the Lord Jesus for forgiveness for any times that we failed. For the times when it was easier to say nothing, we are sorry. Lord, have mercy. The times when we've been unkind to someone, we are sorry. Christ, have mercy. For the times when we've been selfish or dishonest, we are sorry. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Say the glory be to the Father together. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Let us pray. God our Father, God of new beginnings, may this new school year give free rein to our dreams. Give us the courage we need to make our dreams come true. Give us the spirit of growth and of gentleness so that new friendships and new ideas may be born in us. May we be excited by all this year has to offer. And this we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. So we sit down now, please, for the first reading to be read by Anima.
A reading from Romans chapter 8, verses 28 to 30. We are well aware that God works with those who love him, those who have been called in accordance with his purpose, and turns everything to their good. He decided beforehand who were the ones destined to be molded to the pattern of his Son, so that he should be the eldest of many brothers. It was those so destined that he called. Those that he called, he justified, and those that he has justified, he has brought into glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Gia now. Gia coming forward to sound.
Responsorial Psalm. The response is, with delight I rejoice in the Lord.
With delight I rejoice in the Lord.
But I have trusted in thy mercy. My heart shall rejoice in thy salvation.
With delight I rejoice in the Lord.
I will sing to the Lord, who giveth me good things.
With delight I rejoice in the Lord. Thank you. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. This is how Jesus came to be born. His mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, but before they came to live together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a man of honor and wanting to spare her publicity, decided to divorce her informally. He had made up his mind to do this when the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because she has conceived what is in her by the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you must name him Jesus, because he is the one who is to save his people from their sins." Now all this took place to fulfill the words spoken by the Lord through the prophet, "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel," a name which means God is with us. The Gospel of the Lord. And so we begin a whole new year in school. Hopefully you've all had a lovely holiday, a good rest, and you're ready now to do your best, listening to your teachers, listening at home to your parents, and doing all you can to help yourselves with your education. Very, very important, not just for you, but for everyone. But it's the only way you'll do it, of course, is to listen and to do what you're asked to do. And the one thing you must never be afraid of is that you should never be afraid to ask your teachers to explain something if you really do not understand what's been said. Never be afraid, because the teachers are there for you and they want you to ask the question. Never ever be afraid to do that, and in so doing you will learn far more quickly. Mary, the mother whose birthday we're celebrating today, she listened to the Archangel Gabriel when he came to her and told her that she was going to be a mother. And she couldn't understand what he meant by that, because she wasn't married. But she didn't keep silent. She asked the Angel Gabriel, "How can this be?" And the angel Gabriel was able to explain to her, and she listened. And not only did she listen, but she responded, "Let it be done according to your word." Joseph, of course, was a bit distressed when he discovered Mary was pregnant, was expecting a baby. And he was about to leave her. But the angel appeared to him in a dream and said to him, "No, you stay with her, because the baby that she's receiving is from the Holy Spirit." And again, Joseph listened.
and did exactly what the angel Gabriel asked him to do. He took Mary into his home as his wife. And of course, because of both of them saying yes, Jesus came into the world. And that was their reward. And Mary, of course, throughout his life, was with him all the time. Even at the very end, Mary stood at the foot of the cross. She stood at the foot of the cross, no doubt in tears, after witnessing the cruelty that Jesus, her son, had gone through. But she knew this had to happen, because she also knew that Jesus would rise from the dead and conquer sin and death, and that one day each and every one of us will share in his kingdom. But it's for us to live our lives in listening to the word of God. Not just listening, but acting upon it as well, doing all we can to help each other and to support each other. And as you begin your new year in St. Michael's, to make St. Michael's, the school it is, such a very, very good school, it's important that you children do your best to help each other. And when you see a child struggling or lost, especially new children into the school, they're not sure where they should be going, never ever be afraid to go up to them and tell them, guide them, help them, so they can settle into the school quickly and be one of you. It's important that you all help each other and support each other. And in so doing, St. Michael's will be a very happy school, as it's been over the many years. That's what we want to continue. So think of today, the day you had your first Mass for the year 2023-24. You celebrated it on the day of Mary's birthday. And the day we are reminded so much of how Mary responded to the words of Almighty God, and how she followed and did all she could in what the Lord wanted her to do in raising her son Jesus and being with him at all times. It's for us to do what he has asked of us and to be with him at all times. And we can only do this we are prepared to spend a little time in prayer each day, to spend time helping each other, supporting each other, to give some time to the work that we're asked to do in school, spare some time to show our parents how much we love them by listening to them and doing as they ask. So making it not only a happy school, but a happy home. Let us make this day the beginning of a happy new year.
So if Lasihani, Thiago, John, Frankie, Myla, Angel and Gabrielle, if you'd like to all come up, please, for our bidding prayers.
Bishop Allen.
So we all stand, please.
And Canon Bob. And our
God, our Father, you are the special friend of our children. You said to your friends, don't stop the children from coming to me. Bring them back. Put your arms around us now and bless us as we pray.
We pray for the church, Pope Francis, Bishop Allen, Canon Bob, and our deanery priests. Support them in their vocation as they guide us through this school year.
Lord, in your mercy.
We pray for the church, we pray for those who govern. May your spirit fill them with the strength to make good decisions for the good of all.
Lord, in your mercy.
Lord, we ask you to bless our new school year. May we be happy and learn new interesting things. We ask you to bless all our teachers and students, especially the staff and children who are new to the school.
Lord, in your mercy.
We pray for the staff and the pupils who left us last term. We pray that with your love and support that they are successful and happy in their new schools or adventures.
Lord, in your mercy.
We remember those who are sick, unemployed, or in any sort of trouble. May they open their hearts to your love.
Lord, in your mercy.
We pray for the souls of people who have died recently. We pray for Mrs. Ruikun's husband. May he, along with the recently departed, experience the joy of death and be welcomed home to heaven.
Lord, in your mercy.
Mary, as a parent, you would understand new beginnings and the need for
Could you try to say it a bit louder, please, that we can't hear?
Mary, as a parent, you would understand new beginnings and the need for support. Share your understanding and love with us as we say,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Help us, Lord, to use well the talents you have given each of us. Help us to bring them to our studies, so that we work to the best of our ability. May all we do and learn be in your service and in the service of love, both now and in the future. And we ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord. Is there a difference? You sit down now for the offertory, please. Pray, my friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the humanity of your only begotten Son come, O Lord, to our aid. And may he who at his birth from the Blessed Virgin did not diminish but consecrated her integrity by taking from us now our wicked deeds, make our oblation acceptable to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and so praise, bless, and glorify your name on this, the Nativity of the Blessed Virgin Mary. For by overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived her only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty. Dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Kneel down now. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember your church, Lord, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Alan, our Bishop, our clergy, and all our people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Michael and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. The Savior's command, upon by divine teaching, we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. Let us pray. God of new beginnings, guide us with your Spirit as we begin our new school year. May we be aware of our talents and gifts and use them to be a light in one another's lives. May we realize how important each of us is and help us to share the light of Jesus in our school and in our world. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Just want to say a huge thank you to the readers, to the singing, and to you all, and wish you every success and every happiness now in your new school year. Hopefully you all had a very good holiday. Hopefully the teachers had a great rest, and they are ready now to get the ball rolling, that you have a wonderful time. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in the peace and the love of Christ. And we're going to sing our final hymn now.
Immaculate Mary, our hearts are on fire. The title so wondrous fills all our desire. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria, Ave. God's glory, the Lord's kingdom come. We pray for his vicar, our Father and Rome. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria, Ave. Church apart.